Hey designers, get ready to have your creative mind blown. MidJourney just dropped a massive update to their image editor, and it's about to change the game for how we create and edit images. We're not just talking about tweaking MidJourney creations anymore. This update lets you import any image from your computer or the web and unleash the power of MidJourney's AI. That means you can take your own photos, sketches, floor plans, and transform them in ways that you never thought possible. So imagine turning a selfie into a portrait, or give your dog a stylish makeover with sunglasses and a party hat. I'll show you how to do that. Or reimagining an interior with a completely different style, all within MidJourney. This update introduces two groundbreaking features, the edit feature and the retexture feature. In this video, I'm gonna take you through both of these, but just a little bit about the difference between the two. The edit feature lets you make specific changes to your image. So think of it like an AI-powered Photoshop, but better than the AI that's in Photoshop. You can crop, resize, erase unwanted parts, then add new elements by selecting an area and typing in a prompt. But hold on, things are about to get even wilder with the retexture feature. This is going to be a game changer for interior designers. This magical tool lets you completely transform the style and texture of your image while keeping its original shape. So you could have your image reimagined as a watercolor. Possibilities creatively are truly limitless. If you are not a heavy user of MidJourney, you might find that you don't have access to it. This update is so powerful that MidJourney is rolling it out gradually and ensuring that it is being tested thoroughly. Let's take a look at who has access to it. The external editor of MidJourney is only available to subscribers who meet at least one of these requirements: have a yearly subscription, have been subscribed for at least 12 consecutive months with no gaps, or have generated more than 10,000 MidJourney images. The other thing I'd like to point out that you need to agree to a terms of service, and it's important that you do that. So you've got to meet the age requirement, and you've got to follow applicable laws, community guidelines, and so on. We're also responsible for all the content that you input, and you have to have the necessary rights to use and edit the images you upload. So now that I've explained the legalities to you, let's dive in and take a look. In order to show you how we use it, I'm gonna start with this picture that I took of my dog. This thing about it was actually to get him looking at me, which he decided he wasn't going to do. He absolutely hates the camera. Then I hit the erase button here, and you can adjust the brush size, so it'll make it smaller. So you can just do undo, redo as much as you want. So I wanted him to wear a party hat, so my prompt was add a party hat to my dog, and you can see it gave me quite a few options, and I liked this option. Then what I tried to do was to get my dog to wear sunglasses. So I said the prompt add sunglasses to my dog's face, and I highlighted this area, and you can see it came up with a whole heap of pretty cool sunglasses. I chose this one. The party hat remains. Then I tried to add in a sweater. So this, you can see, I tried to add in a Memphis inspired jumper to my dog, and I deleted this part. You can see here, MidJourney did not understand it. I tried a couple of times. I took out more, and again, add a bright sweater to my dog's body. And you can see again, MidJourney struggled here to try and interpret this. Then I tried again by actually adding a style reference. So you'll see here, we can actually click on this, and I uploaded this video of this very similar looking dog in a pink sweater. So I clicked this, and you will see here, when you click on it, you have three options. This person, which is a character reference. Let's say I wanted to change this picture to a cat. I might actually upload a picture of a cat. Then you've got a style reference, And here is the image prompt. So what I want to actually do is I want to tell MidJourney that I want the bright woolen sweater to look like this. So I used the style reference and I deleted this area, and you'll see MidJourney was able to understand what I meant here. Didn't cover this part of Buddy's body. So I went back in and I highlighted this prompt and I ran exactly the same thing again, and you will see the finished result was this. So this is the power of a style reference. So you might be asking me, well, that's all very well and good of dressing up your dog. Well, how can this work with interior design images? So let me show you. Now that I've briefly explained to you the power of MidJourney, I want to just go backwards somewhat and just check out the main interface. So you will see here you've got an explore tab, and this is actually something that I do recommend that you go through, because particularly if you're interested in interior design, you might want to check out some of the prompts. So I usually like to flick through and see if there's any prompts that are relevant to my work. I always just like to copy these and put them through MidJourney to kind of get a feel of the results that you get and the differences in the generation. So I do recommend that you start here once you do get access to the interface, and you can see there is plenty of inspiration here that you can look at. And I've done exactly that and used some of the prompts that I've actually copied to see what I actually came up with. Let's say we have an image that we like, and I'm going to pick this image here. So you can see here, this is an image I generated in MidJourney. Quite a lot of texture in this background. I want to change some of the materials of this image. I'm going to want to go back into the edit tab. I'm going to go right back to the original. And what I've actually done is I've generated a mood board here of marble material. So the prompt for this was flat lay mood board for an interior design project presented on a timber tray, pieces of marble tile. What you can do is you go into here, you can actually just download or save this image any way that you want. You can see there's a download button here. Then you can upload it to your create button. So if you go into edit, you can then upload this by clicking on this button and you can choose a file. Also got the image. I'm going to use it as a style reference. And then I'm going to take my brush and then delete this because I want to change this countertop to a light marble. You can obviously adjust the brush size here, make it larger or smaller. And I've deleted this. When I've done that, I hit submit. Edit. So you can see here it actually has changed the countertop, and you can see there's a few different styles. You can actually just regenerate it until you get a result that you like. Otherwise, you could actually try a different image. So for example, it could be that this image, there's too much going on. Again, it's not kind of giving me the image that I want, and I'm going to create a lighter material. So I'm going to have none and then go in and choose a white marble and then hit save. Then we can go back into the image editor and we can add in another image and then drop it in here, and we can try that, and you can see the results are much better. So if you aren't getting the results that you would like, I suggest you have a more specific example. Okay, so let's just jump into a couple of other examples. So here, which is another mood board, but I wanted to change everything to blue. I erased this area around. And let's just take a look at some of the results that I got on basically deleting it again and again. If the image had problems, I deleted again. And you can see after every iteration, it did actually improve. The other feature is this one that is called Retexture. And Retexture is going to change the content of the image, but try to preserve the original structure. What I'd like to do is take this image and I want to change it to a sketch style. Here I've got a sketch. Now let's say I want to have a particular style. Let's say I have a style like this. Let me just show you. And I want it in this style. What I can do is again, go into this as a style reference. So remember, this is the paperclip symbol. And then just submit the retexture and we'll use this as our style reference. It's actually interpreted it really well in this. So if you've got a particular style of your own, then you can actually reinterpret your images very, very similar to your style, which will save you a ton of work. So you can see here when I actually asked for the sketch style image, it gave me a few different options. This way, if you've got a particular style, it can actually understand and copy that style. Now, once you've done this, you can just upscale it to a gallery, which will give you a high resolution image. Finally, I wanted to show you how else you could integrate it into your design process. Let's say you take a picture of a room. So this is a real life image of a bedroom. And I've actually used the prompt, a mid-century modern style bedroom. So you can see here, it's actually relatively similar. It's reinterpreted it. You can keep on generating images to suit any design that you have, but it is an incredibly quick for idea generation. With a mid-century modern style with dark walls, and you can see here, it's actually added in those dark walls. Again, here's another example. I added this picture and you can see this is the original image. And I've said this New York style living room with dark walls and Art Nouveau furniture. I'm not sure whether it's interpreted the Art Nouveau furniture, but you can see it's actually very similar to the architecture that's been given in the prompt. Then said a similar living room to this with dark furniture in the style of Shane McGee. So again, there's lots of different examples here. And then I said, okay, this living room, again, the similar living room, but in the style of Zaha Hadid. It's definitely understood and reinterpreted the curves. Another very, very quick use is, let's say you wanted to see what drapes would look like in a room like this. So you can see here, obviously there's architectural detail that isn't present in the original image, but it does give you an idea about what long full length drapes would look like in this interior. Again, we've got our bedroom example, and I've said reinterpret it as a set from a Wes Anderson film, and then I could actually add in this as a reference. So let's have a look at this still, and then let's just use that as a style reference. And you can see here, it's taken the color palette, the image, and interpreted it in this bedroom. So this is a really, really easy way that you can see what a similar bedroom might look like. Another example is, let's say you had a particular piece of furniture, this image of the living room, and I want to see what it would look like with this particular marble table. So you can see here, I've added this as a style reference and I've got my image. And the prompt was a living room with a green marble coffee table, similar to this one. And you can see the first one in particular is very, very close. So you can really see how it might look in the room. It's even got the lighting right. That's very similar to the way that this room was shot. So here's another example. You had this image of a bedroom, again, created by MidJourney. I then had this side table, and I want to put a similar side table in this image. We've got these black side tables here, and I want to see what a lighter side table would look like. I've used this side table as a reference, and you can see this bedroom, the prompt is very simply this bedroom with side tables like this. Using this as a side reference, it's changed the tables so that you can actually see the difference. I still can't believe how far MidJourney has developed in a year. And I hope watching this video has given you some ideas of how you can integrate MidJourney into your workflow. AI is truly here to stay and is impacting the design industry at every level. So make sure you integrate it into your workflow responsibly and ethically. It's still very early days with this tool and I am still experimenting. If you do have access to the new editor, jump in and experiment too. I'll be updating this video regularly as MidJourney continues to develop. I'll also be posting further videos about how you can use AI in your design workflow. So make sure you subscribe so that you can see my prompts and images. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.